Hi guys, it's Sherry. I hope you are having a wonderful day. Today it's going to be quick, but cute. Stay tuned. My crafty friends out there, if you are making crafts that have been inspired by this channel, make sure that you upload photos on Instagram using the hashtag #PoshPaperLadyInspired. It's going to be awesome sharing your creations with everybody out there in the social media world. So make sure that you proudly upload all of the wonderful and amazing crafts that you guys are doing. Hashtag #PoshPaperLadyInspired on Instagram. So today, guys, we're going to switch gears just a little bit. We are going to make an awesome, awesome cookie, donut, cupcake, whatever you want to call it, little pastry box, because this is probably one of the most requested boxes I actually get. And it is, can you make something for me to box up a bunch of cookies or cupcakes or whatever types of goodies you might be making. And I decided that I would, but I wanted to just go ahead and just delve into Halloween just a little bit. I know that a lot of you don't celebrate Halloween, but we do have a lot of people who do. So I am going to be doing some Halloween crafting as well as some of the other crafting that you guys see me do. So for those of you who don't celebrate Halloween, this is, as I always say, in any season, any reason, any gender, gift. All you need to do is swap out the papers and the embellishments, and this can become whatever it is that you need for it to be. So what I have here is just a very simple and very cute Halloween card. And I made it using some Halloween colored paper as well as a Halloween cut apart. And this is all in fun, but I thought it was really cute. And then we have this wonderful peekaboo box that is perfect. Perfect for holding those goodies that you might want to make to gift. I am going to slide off my ribbon that I used to tie it. And then I'll open it up so that you can see exactly how this sweet box is made. And guys, this is a big one because this box measures 7 by 3.5 by 3. And so you can get a lot of your goodies inside of this box and super cute to boot. Let's make it. All right, guys, so to make the box, we are going to need a 12 by 12 piece of decorative cardstock. Mine is single-sided, but if you have double-sided cardstock, that'll work well too. And then I have a template for cutting the window that measures 3 by 4. And then I have a piece of acetate that measures 4 by 5. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to score this every 2 3/4 inches. So our first score is at 2 3/4. Then we'll make the second score at 5.5. My 5.5 mark on this board is in a really odd spot, so I'm just going to move over that mark I made so that I can get the proper marking. So again, that's 2 3/4, 5.5, 8 1/4, and then 11. Then I'll rotate it to the opposite side, and we're going to score this at 2.5. Rotate it to the opposite side of that 2.5-inch score. Score again at 2.5. And then we need to fold and burnish all of our scores. And my paper is thick, so I am going to make sure that I am getting a really good burnish on this. And almost done with that folding and that burnishing. All right, guys, so now that we have all of the folding and the burnishing done, this narrow flap here is the flap that will go inside or on the outside of your box. So we need to get rid of these two pieces right here. And this is one of those projects that whatever I do here, I need to do here. So I am going to come in with my finger blade. And the first thing that I'm going to do, because I'll have to make an angle cut here, is I am going to make a very deep angle cut. And then I'll make a very slight angle cut. So it's going to look like that. I'm going to go ahead and rotate it to this side. Place my finger blade right there and do that deep angle cut. And then here, we will do a very slight angle cut. So when you have these two pieces removed, this is what it's going to look like. So now what we need to do is we need to go up to the first score mark on all of these tabs and just free them up. And again, we need to rotate it to this side and we are going to do the same thing. So just free up that tab. And now we have our tabs cut out. We're going to flip this over so that we can place our template piece. And the template piece is the piece that measures 3x4. So I'm gonna flip it back over because it might be easier for you guys to see what I'm about to do on this side. So where we place the template is between panels 1 and 2. I am just going to place mine so that most of the opening is here on the front and a little bit of the opening overlaps on the back. So if you have a die cutter and you want to put this in the die cutter, you can. This technique here is for anyone who doesn't have a die cutter, but you want that cute look that you get with an acetate window. So I have a piece that measures 3x4. I am going to place that down like so. Then I'll use my big old spatula to get that stuck. Then I'll use my finger blade. And all I'm going to do is trace around this template and remove it. And that is just a very quick and easy way to get an opening. Okay guys, so once we have our opening cut, we need to bring in our acetate piece that measures 5x4. And what I'm going to do is run a very thin bead of glue along the outer edge of that acetate. Now I can take the acetate and place it over my opening. Then I'm going to take my paper towel and I am simply going to start moving that glue by pressing in the opposite direction of that opening. So basically what I'm doing, if I take my spatula, put it down, I'll push that way and I'll push like that and I'll put it here and push this way. That way I'm getting my glue stuck, but I'm not driving it towards the opening of the window and I don't have to worry about cleaning up glue from that acetate window. So now we have our acetate opening. Now what I like to do, because it makes it easier to keep your box closed, just fold it on the natural score line and I'm not going to burnish the acetate, but I am going to burnish on the paper where you can feel the acetate underneath. And this just helps you to keep your box nice and closed. So the way that we close the box is, this is the glue flap here, the first one. So we will fold that up. Then we bring up this one from the back and we start putting it down. So one thing that I want to do before I start gluing it together is, I think I want to reduce this just a little bit. So it's that middle flap. So all I'm doing is removing half of it like this. So now I'll take it and I am going to place glue on that first portion there. Then I can bring this piece up, but before I do that, I want to place some glue along the bottom so that it will stay stuck at the bottom. So I'm going to bend that back just a little bit. Then when I bring it in, I want to make sure that I have the bottom aligned. And then I will use my big old spatula just to go in and get it stuck. And now I'll come over to the other side and do the same thing. So I am going to add my glue here. Then I'll add some glue along the bottom of this back flap. Then I can take these two, join them just like that, and I'll use my big old spatula just to get in on the inside and get that stuck. So now I need to bend this back out of the way just a little bit because it is in the way, y'all. So I am going to take some glue, place some glue on this flap here, and attach it here. So I am going to place my glue all over this flap. And then I can take this flap. I am going to join it with this one, but I want to make sure that the tops are even. If they're uneven at the bottom, I can go back and fix that. So I'm going to use my spatula, go on the inside to get everything nice and stuck. Then I'll come over to this side and we are going to repeat it. So I'll place my glue all over this little piece here. Then I'll take this piece, making sure that I have it even at the top. Then I'll open it up, go on the inside, and get everything nice and stuck. And so now I should have a box that I can close. And if I tuck that in, isn't that stinking cute? I absolutely love it. So when you put your goodies on the inside, whoever you're giving this to, they are going to be blown away and amazed, A, that you made this box, and B, that it is so stinking cute. So one of the things that I want to do to this box is I want to add some pieces along here and along here just to kind of finish off the sides. So what I have a piece that measures 1.5 by 7, and I have two pieces that measure 1.5 by 3.5. And I am going to take my scoreboard, use my stylus, and I am just going to score this in half. So I'm basically scoring at 3/4 of an inch on all of these pieces that I have here. And now I'll just fold these and give them a little very light burnishing. And now I can take these and just do a very quick test fit. So I'm going to take the striped long piece and put it on the front. That fits. So I am going to take my glue, place my glue all over this so I can put it down. And now I'll put it in just like this. And that's how it's going to look. I'm going to lift that up out of the way, go on the inside with my spatula, get it stuck, and that just gives us a nice professional front to that. Okay guys, so now I'll take my piece that measures 2 3/4 and I'll do the same thing that I did on the front. I am going to take this piece and place it down. Stand it up just like this. And this time I'm just going to use my ruler because it's easy to get on the inside with the ruler on that smaller piece. And now I have This side looking just as gorgeous as the front. I have already done this side, so we have a beautifully finished box. Now I'm going to close it, and you can close this however you want. You can have the outside showing like this, and you can close that outside with the magnet, or you can do as I'm going to do and just tuck it on the inside because I like the way that that looks. So now that we have this, all we really need to do is decorate. And how you decorate your box, guys, that is completely up to you. But I think what I am going to do is I am just going to make myself just a little twine bow, not a big one. So I'm using 3 fingers and I'm just wrapping it around. Then when I have the number of loops that I want, I'll leave the tail piece here. Then I'll take the piece that I was wrapping around my finger and I'll run it through that very first loop and I'll pull it, but I'm not pulling it tight because if you pull it tight, it will unravel. So all I want to do with this one is I am going to place that right there. So I am going to just use a little bit of my reptile glue, place it on this cute piece of Halloween ephemera, and then I can take the Halloween ephemera, place some glue on the back of that, and put it down. So when you put those Halloween cookies in here, or whatever it is you might put in yours, you have got this awesomely sweet little box just to be able to wow people with. Because really, guys, it does have that wow factor. So I am going to bring in the other one so you can see the difference in how I actually finished these off. So what I did on this one, just attached a little bow to the top and my piece of ephemera. Then on this one, I am attaching a wraparound twine bow, and then my piece of ephemera will just be tucked under there and I'll hold it down with some glue. But you can see just how sweet these little boxes are, even though mine are themed for Halloween. This would be perfect for just mini goodies to help celebrate a birthday or any special occasion that you might be having. Now, we want to make a card to go along with this. All right, guys, this is going to be a very simple card. I have a piece of my coordinating paper here that measures 8x5. And all I'm going to do is fold it in half, just like this. And y'all know I'm not a card maker, so I go with the simplest process possible. And then I have my folded card. So I now have a card that is 4x5. And all I'm going to do is just take one of my little cut aparts and put it down, and that one says something wicked this way comes. And I'm going to just use my tape runner to place my tape on my card. Then I can take the sweet little ephemera card, place it down. So then I can make myself an awesome envelope to go along with this, and we would have a gorgeous gift set. So for a birthday, Christmas, whatever the occasion is, you can make personal edible gifts to give to someone and present them in the sweet, gorgeous box along with a well-coordinated little card. So I am going to bring that first one back in so y'all can see all of this goodness, and I need to clean off my desk. But here we go, guys. Isn't this just simple, easy, and fabulous? Because we want everything that we do on this channel to be fabulous. We want all of those wonderful projects that you guys are making to be fabulous and like no other. We don't want the same old, same old. We want to go next level with what we're doing, and I think that we're doing a pretty good job at it. So guys, I hope that you have liked this quick and easy project. If you have, please hit the like button. If you are not a subscriber to my channel, I would love to have you join my online crafting family. You guys have a great day. Happy crafting, and we'll chat later. Bye.